In this lesson, we're going to be looking at the foundations of ratio and how we go about solving problems with them. We'll look at calculating equivalent ratios, which have the same proportion but use larger or smaller numbers. We're going to practice a key element for solving ratios questions, and then we'll look at how the parts of a ratio can be written as a fraction. Next, we'll be looking at how they can write them with decimals, and finally, how to solve what I tend to call comparative ratios. Firstly, let's have a look at what a ratio actually is. A ratio is the relationship of one amount to another. We tend to call this relationship proportionality, but the method of writing the shares is called a ratio. Ratios can use different numbers, but remain proportionally the same, and this is referred to as creating equivalent ratios. The numbers can get bigger or smaller, but the proportion between them remains the same. This is done using multiplication or division. And if we take this example of a ratio of 6 to 2, we can see that the proportion difference is that the first group of shares is 3 times the size of the second group of shares. If we multiply both sides by 2, we can create an equivalent ratio of 12 to 4. The proportionality still remains the same. If we then multiply both sides by 100, for instance, we have a ratio of 1200 to 400. Obviously, we can continue to increase these numbers, but actually reversing this effect is a really useful tool called simplifying. This means dividing both sides by the highest common factor, the biggest number that has both 1200 and 400 in its times tables. To get to the smallest integers or whole numbers whilst keeping the proportionality the same. The highest common factor of 1200 and 400 is 400. So we can divide both sides by 400 to get the ratio of 3 to 1. And this is the ratio written in its simplest form. The use of factors of numbers is an area that's repeated throughout GCSE mathematics, and in fact, in many areas beyond. Next, we're going to look at a key element for solving ratios questions, finding the value of a single share. In the majority of ratio problems, this is vital to us being able to solve this type of problem. Here, we have a question regarding Amy and Bill sharing £72 between them in the ratio of 5 to 3. Now, one thing to remember is when you look at these questions, which part of the ratio relates to which person. In this instance, Amy would get 5 shares and Bill would get 3 shares. The reason for that is the order that they are set out in the question, and it relates to the order they are in the ratio. Amy would get 5 shares and Bill would get 3 shares. To solve this problem, we need to find out what one share is worth. To accomplish that, we need to calculate the total amount of shares, and we can do that by adding 5 to 3, which would make 8. We divide the 72 by £8 to give £9, and we can then times Amy's 5 shares by £9 to make 45, and Bill's 3 shares by £9 to make 27. We can then write this as the ratio 45 to 27. And we can check those add together to make 72 as follows. The proportionality remains the same, as we are multiplying both sets of shares by the same number. Next, we have a problem where Charlie, Dan, and Edith share some money in the ratio of 5 to 6 to 2. Now again, remember, which ones have which part of the ratio? So Charlie will have 5 shares, Dan will have 6 shares, and Edith will have 2 shares. As with the last problem, the key to solving this is finding out what one share is worth. We don't know what they're going to get in total, but we know that Charlie gets 5 shares, and that equals £350. So we'll take the 350 and divide it by 5 to find one share, which is £70. We can then take the one share of £70 and times it by 6 to find out how much Dan gets, which will be £420. And then we can times 70 by 2 to see that Edith gets £140. So the final ratio is 350 to 420 to 140. On this next problem, we have Oscar and Monica sharing some money in the ratio of 2 to 5. The next piece of information we have is that Monica gets £18 more than Oscar. So the question is how much they share altogether. Here, we're not told how much they're sharing in total, and we're not being told how much they each receive, but we're being told that Monica gets £18 more. So let's have a look at the ratio. In the ratio, did you notice that Monica gets 3 shares more than Oscar? If we know that Monica gets £18 more than Oscar, we therefore know that 3 shares equals 18. Once again, we're going to divide £18 by 3. And that shows us that one share equals £6. We can then multiply by 2 to get Oscar's share, of £12, and we can multiply by 5 to get Monica's share of £30. We can check by looking to see if Monica still receives £18 more. 30 subtract 12 equals 18. However, if we check the question, it asks how much they share altogether. We can add Monica and Oscar's shares together, 30 plus 12, to get £42 in total. In all of these problems, we solved them by calculating one share to find out the rest of the ratio. In the next section, we'll look at how ratios can be written as fractions. Ratios are shown as a number of shares to a number of shares. In order to find out the total of the parts, we add all the shares together. This will give us the whole amount that is used in that ratio. But when we look at fractions, the shares for one group is over the whole amount of parts for whatever is being divided. This is then directed towards the particular name or area that the fraction represents. For instance, if we took Amy and Bill, who shared their £72 in the ratio of 5 to 3. Amy would have 5 out of the total of 8 shares, or 5/8. We can check that by calculating what 5/8 of 72 is. So dividing 72 by 8 and timesing it by 5 would give us £45. This is the same as the amount we calculated using the shares of the ratio. In this section, we're going to look at a different way that ratios can be displayed in answering a question. Ratios tend to be written using whole numbers or integers. And if asked to simplify a ratio, we take the numbers to the lowest integer that we can use. Occasionally, we're asked to write the ratio in a form that forces us to use decimals. For instance, 1 to n. This means that a ratio must be simplified so that one of the parts has to be reduced to 1, regardless of what the proportionality does to the other section or sections, which could end up as decimals or mixed numbers. For example, Oscar and Monica shared the money in the ratio of 2 to 5. So Oscar and Monica, 2 to 5, which was 12 to 30, because we times both sides by 6. But if we take it that Oscar and Monica got 2 to 5 in the ratio, we have to divide the 2 by 2, because that first share for Oscar needs to be 1. So we need to do the same to the other side. By dividing it by 2, you get 2.5. If this was required to be given in the ratio of 1 to n, we would write this as 1 to 2.5. Because we've divided the 2 by 2 to get to 1, and need to do the same to the other side to maintain the proportionality. Lastly, we're going to look at how to solve questions that have two ratios that have a comparative element. If we look at this ratio from the question with Charlie and Dan and Edith, we have their shares in the ratio of 5 to 6 to 2. If we have another ratio where we compare Edith to Fred, we can see that in this ratio, Edith gets 5 shares compared to Fred's 2 shares. In order to calculate how much Fred is going to receive, we need to start off by using the multiple of £70 per share from Charlie's total in the original ratio that we worked out. So 350 divided by 5 would give us 70. We can then times that by 6 to get the £420 for Dan, and we can times it by 2 to get the £140 for Edith. We can then move that over to Edith's shares. Edith, 140 divided by Edith's 5 shares, that gives us a multiple of £28 per share. We can now multiply Fred's 2 shares to find that he receives £56. Through this lesson, you've been able to see how we go about calculating equivalent ratios. Using that element of finding one share to solve these types of ratio questions. We've looked at how ratios can be written as fractions and how to use the shares or parts of the ratio in that context. We also looked at how a ratio can be written with decimals. And lastly, we looked at how to use comparative ratios to solve questions that involve more than one ratio that have a shared element. In the next video, we will look at the use of proportionality in dealing with questions around recipes. And I'll see you then.